We will start. Okay. The class will start from 1:10 p.m. Let everyone join. Okay. And regarding the previous class, is there any query or problem you have? Okay. Very good. So Google Classroom was already created, and the first PPT, the study material, already I shared there. But I didn't get any time to share the name of the books. So today I will give the name of the books and from which book you should read what topic, that will be uploaded there. Okay, no need.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I didn't get the study material, sir.
Oh, it is already given in Google Classroom. In the group, already I gave the link to join in the Google Classroom, okay? And
okay,
Muhammad Sohail Khan, don't give your attendance right now. I am repeatedly telling you, do not give your attendance. After the end of the class, I will give you 5 minutes or 10 minutes. At that time, you should give your attendance, okay?
Sir, yesterday I was unable to give attendance, sir. That's why I gave earlier.
No need. You have my WhatsApp number. So if you missed by any chance, just inform me. I will add.
Yes, okay. I informed you yesterday.
Okay, so then, okay. Then I have added, I
think. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay, is the screen visible? The module 1.2 PPT?
Yes,
no,
sir.
No, sir.
Okay, now is this visible? The new
yes,
module.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so after 5 minutes, the class will start. And please remember, the class starts from 1 p.m. okay, or 3 p.m. according to the schedule. But after 15 minutes, I won't allow anyone. Okay, so be present before the 15 minutes of the commencement of the class. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, so we have till 4 minutes. Okay, so I just want to discuss with you something. Tell me that whether you have any one of you have inverter at home?
Yes, sir.
Inverter, AC, some of you already have. Okay, so what is the main function of that inverter? Can anyone tell me, because that is that concept of inverter already, it will be taught, okay, in module 5. We have time, but I just want to know, because we have already 3 minutes time, so just tell me.
Sir, it convert DC into AC, sir, I think.
Okay, so it converts DC into AC. So how it is actually working when our power supply is on, our normal current is coming, we can light the fan, light the switch, your bulb, we can switch on the fan. But when the load shedding occurs, then the inverter supplies the power. Right, that is the main concept, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so how it is converting DC into AC? DC means direct current and AC means alternating current. So how it is converting? Do you have any idea?
No, sir.
Okay, so when you bought or when your parents bought that inverter, in your mind you didn't have any question at that time that how it is converting or how it is actually working. You have switchboard at home, and in that switchboard you have seen the fuse, you have AC, and in that AC switch there are different types of switches are connected. Okay, so whenever you saw something like that, it will something unusual. Unusual means you know something, but what you are observing, that is different than your knowledge. So ask question. Okay, whatever you are observing at home, all those everything's are included in this basic electrical engineering. Okay, the basic concept of inverter is when the power supply from the grid we are getting, then at that time it is charging. Okay, the inverter is connected with a battery. You have seen that. Okay, ek inverter ke sath ek battery hamesha connected rehta hai. Okay, so us battery ke andar hai kya? Do you know what is inside that battery?
Electrolyte and electrode.
Very good. And electrolyte and electrode. So when the current passes inside that inverter, there is a particular connection. Okay, I will show you. Like your MOSFET, your BJT I have shown you, SCR thyristor I have shown you. So a group of thyristors are connected such a way that, okay, let me, a group of thyristors are connected such a way it can convert electrolyte. Okay, and when the load shedding occurs, then that energy stored, that chemical energy stored in the electrolyte will again convert it into the electrical energy, DC energy. Okay, then again that group of thyristor converts that DC energy into AC energy and supplies into our household appliances. That is the main concept. Okay, okay, now you have seen in local train, have you seen some fans are stopped and there are some people who just bring out one pin and rotate the fan just by giving it a stroke?
Yes, sir.
Have you seen that? So
yes, sir.
How is it happening? How is happening? That is again one basic electrical engineering question. Okay, so this type of question I will discuss, okay, in this free time. So okay, so just remember this question, I will discuss it tomorrow. Okay, just remember this one that sir told me that how that fan rotate in the train, in local train. Okay, I will tell you.
And sir, how the chain of train works?
Oh, great question. Okay, so today it is already 1:12, so that question will be, answer will be given tomorrow. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so keep that question in your mind, right? So
right.
Tomorrow, for today, these numericals will be taught first, right? So in this numerical, am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So we have to find out the equivalent resistance across that XY. We have XY two ports are here, right? And we have to calculate the equivalent resistance. So you can see the combination of series and parallel resistances are here. So just by looking at this picture, you can say very easily. How? Here, check this 3 and 6. These two are in parallel. So what we will do? 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3. So this combination's equivalent resistance is 2. 6 into 3, 18. 6 plus 3, 9. So 18 by 9 equal to 2 ohm. So I am writing here 2 ohm. Next, check 1, 2 and 5. All these are connected in parallel. So what we will write? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 5 equal to our 1 by R equivalent 1. Okay. This is your R equivalent 2. Okay. So calculate this one. 5 to 10. This is your 10 plus
excuse me, sir.
5 plus, yes,
sir.
Yes,
sir. Screen is visible, sir.
Screen is not visible. Okay. No one can see this.
It is visible, sir.
It is visible, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
It is visible, sir.
Okay. Fine. Okay, so those who cannot see this screen, just log out once and then again join via the link given. Okay, I will accept the link. I will accept, admit you. Okay, then I think you can see that screen. If any problem, any type of problem may occur. Okay, so this is your 17 by 10. So your, just a minute. Okay, so your equivalent resistance here is 10 by 17, right? Now see, this 2 ohm, 10 by 17 ohm, and here again 2 ohm are in series connection. So final is 2 plus 10 by 17 plus 2 ohm. Okay, and this is the resistance of this branch. Okay, again check, 5 ohm is here. So again, this portion is in parallel with 5 ohm. Okay, this notation, if you don't know, let me tell you, this notation means the two branches are in parallel. Okay, this connection, the double line, this connection means it is parallel sign. Okay, so you can find the equivalent resistance easily. Here, check, it is already solved. Okay, now next, find out the equivalent capacitance of the combination shown in the figure. Now if the capacitance are connected in series combination, then what we will do, we will do the parallel calculation, right? So two parallel means your equivalent C for this section is 1 microfarad. Okay. And this 2 microfarad, this one, is in parallel with 1 microfarad. So this whole section's equivalent capacitance will be calculated via series combination. So 2 plus 1, 3 microfarad.
3 microfarad.
Right. Then again, this 3 microfarad is in series with this 1 microfarad. So calculation will be done in parallel. So 3 parallel 1 microfarad. Okay. So you can see it is done here, 3/4 microfarad. Okay. So this one is easy. Now, next you have to find out this equivalent capacitance of the combination. This one is little bit tricky. Why? Because check the combination. There are several types of combination: series, parallel. Okay. So you can see the innermost C1 and C2 are in series. So here we will do the parallel calculation. Check here, parallel calculation is done. Then check this one. This section. So C3 is in parallel. So calculation will be done in series. Correct. Next, consider this C4. C4 is in series. So our calculation will be done in parallel. Then again, the total, this section is in parallel with C5. So our calculation will be done via series. So this C equivalent 2 must be in series calculation with C5. Again, the total section is in parallel with C6, right? So parallel calculation is done here with C6. Clear? So this one is easy. Okay. Now, determine the current drawn from the battery. Okay. Now, in this circuit, you can see a 50 volt battery is connected. Now, what kind of source is this? It is independent source, independent voltage source. Okay. Now, the positive direction is given. So, current will go from positive to negative. Correct? That's why I direction is given. Now, we have to calculate this I. This I value we need to calculate. So, what we have to do? We have to check the equivalent resistance of this section. So how to calculate? See, these 2 and 2 are in parallel. These are resistors. So equivalent resistance will be 1 for this section. Okay, let me erase this first. So your equivalent resistance is 1 here. Okay, again, check the 4 and 4 ohm here. 4 and 4 ohm are in series. So net is 8 ohm. Now 1 ohm and 8 ohm are in parallel. So parallel calculation is done here. Again, that total connection is in series with 10, right? Because this is your 10, this one is your 1, and with the parallel connection, 8 ohm is connected, and here the battery is connected. Correct? So 1, this one is 8, this one is 10. So 1 and 8 are in parallel, then 10 in series, so 10.89 ohm, and our total current flow is 50/10.89, so 4.6 ampere is our total current flow flowing through the circuit from the source, because this one is our source. This battery is our source. Okay. Now, this is the homework for you. Try to do this at home. Okay. Now, several assignments are given for you. This is just the work you have to do on your own. Okay. In next class, we will solve this one first. then we will start the next one. Okay, and if you can remember the previous work I showed you, there was one assignment that I told you we will solve this today. This one, number 3. The current and voltage profile of an element versus time has been shown. This one, ampere and volt. Now we have to determine the element and its value. Okay. Now, here, from the figure, you can see that the ampere value is increasing. Okay, what is the meaning of slope? The slope means the y-axis by x-axis. Okay, that means ampere by time. Now, that slope is constant. You can see this, the slope is always constant. But in case of resistor, there is no slope, right? In case of capacitor, there is no slope of current, there will be slope of voltage. Because there we get, in case of capacitor, we get the value of dV dt. So we will get the slope of voltage, not current. But in case of an inductor, we will get the slope of current di by dt. So just by looking at this current configuration, this graph, you can easily say that this is the waveform of an inductor. Okay, and also see, the voltage is constant, but the and slope is also constant. Now when this can happen, the voltage and slope, right? So in case of inductor only, this can happen. Clear? Now see, what is the slope here? Can you calculate? The, this is 1, this one is 5, okay? So di dt value is 1 by 5, and what is your voltage? 2. So 2 equals to 1 by 5, that means di dt into L. So L value is 10 Henry. Okay? Clear? Now, so this second PDF, the second PPT is complete. Now we are moving to the third one. Okay. Now assignments will be uploaded today in the Google Classroom. So just try that numericals that have been given as your assignment. No need to upload that right now. I will give one separate assignment for you. Okay. And all of you,
excuse me, sir.
Yes,
sir. How will we submit assignments to you?
I will show you. I will show you. No need to panic. Okay. I will show you. I will give every description.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, fine. So now we will learn some common DC terms. Okay. First one, circuit, that you already know, where there is a closed loop, that is called a circuit. Okay, through which the electrical current can flow, that is a closed loop. If you connect one battery here and one resistor to connect here, but you kept this portion open, so this is called the open circuit. Okay, no current will flow. This is called open circuit. And if you connect this by a wire, maybe a copper wire or aluminium wire, okay, so that is called closed circuit. So total two types of circuit are there. One is open circuit, another one is closed circuit. And check, this battery is connected with this resistor via a wire, okay. This is called the, through that wire current will flow. So this is called a path. Okay. Now next point is a node. When two or three elements are connected where a junction can be formed, that point is called a node. Okay. Now consider this circuit. Okay. Here you can see one resistor R1 is connected with R3, R2. R3 resistor is connected with R5, R4. So here check, one junction is formed, right? Now this is called node. Okay, here also check, R3 is connected with R5, that is also connected with R4. So this junction is called a node. Okay, now next one is the branch. What is branch? A branch is a single or group of components such as resistor or a source which are connected between two nodes. That means if there is any element connected between the nodes, that is called a branch. Okay, so that means this is a branch, right? Now you can also check that one R5 is connected, this one is R8. Okay, this is R8, this one, lower one, this one is called R8. Okay, now this R8 is connected with the R4 and R7. So here another node has been formed. Now in between this node and this node, another branch is present. This is another branch. Okay, so concept of branch node is clear, I think. Next one is a loop. A loop means a closed path, simple. A loop means a closed path in a circuit. Okay, when no element is considered twice. Like, suppose you take this circuit. Okay, what you can see? A voltage source and one resistor is connected. Okay, so just let me erase this one. Okay, so if you move from this battery positive part to the negative, so you can see the battery is considered only once and this resistor is also considered only once. So this is called a loop. Here also, if you move like this, it is also called one loop, because this is a closed path and also the R1 and this resistor, this voltage source, this are considered only once when we move like this manner. Okay, next one is a mesh. What is mesh? A mesh is a simply path through a circuit that starts and ends at the same place. Okay, that means what? That means if you start from here, okay, if you start from here and you are moving like this, okay, so this is called one mesh, right? If you move like this, that is also one mesh. So that's why we can say that mesh is a loop that does not enclose the other loops. Okay, mesh is also like a loop, but it does not enclose the other loops. That is the difference between mesh and loop. Okay, now next one we will learn, we will discuss the basic laws. Okay, here this is called the Kirchhoff's first law. Okay, now is the screen visible?
Yes sir.
Okay, so this is the Kirchhoff's first law, which is called the current law. Okay, there are two laws proposed by the Kirchhoff, KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, and KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, what is the main concept of Kirchhoff's law, Kirchhoff's current law? It tells us that if two or more branches are connected at one point, so one node will be created here. Okay, and according to Kirchhoff's law, the summation of current at this node must be always zero. Is it clear? If the current flowing by the branches and they come to this node, then the summation of current must be always zero. That means, suppose I1 is flowing here, I2 is flowing here, okay, I3 is flowing here, and I4 is flowing. Okay, now you see the direction of currents are different. Okay, I1, I2, I3 are same. These type of current is called incoming current. Okay, these are incoming current, and this I4 current is called the outgoing current. So I1, I2, I3, according to Kirchhoff's current law, the algebraic sum of all current must be same. That means what? The I1 plus I2 plus I3, this is your incoming current at this node, okay, N node, and what is your outgoing current? That is I4. Okay, so this is the Kirchhoff's current law. That means the total summation of current, because I1 plus I2 plus I3 minus I4 equals to zero. It is the summation of current, right, across this, at this node N. Here five branches are there. Check, I1, I2, I3 are incoming currents, and I5 and I4 are outgoing currents. Okay, so here the incoming currents are considered as plus and outgoing currents are considered as minus. So this is the equation that we are developing based on the Kirchhoff's current law. We can also write it like this: I1 plus I2 plus I3 equals to I4 plus I5. That means incoming current equals to outgoing current. Okay, here it is also, you can write like exiting current and entering current. Okay, both are equally right, but when you are writing the Kirchhoff's current law, the law must be same to everyone, because you cannot change one law. Okay, so this law you have to remember: the total current or charge entering a junction or node is exactly equal to the charge leaving the node, as it has no other place to go except to leave, as no charge is lost within the node. Okay, clear? This is called the conservation of charge, because what is charge? Charge is nothing but the current into time, right? So here the total current is constant. Okay, now if the total current is constant, that means what? Current into time, the total amount of charge is also constant. So that's why it is also called the conservation of charge. Okay, this may be given as MCQ in exam. So remember, KCL law is called the conservation of charge law also. Now, next is the second law, that is called the Kirchhoff's voltage law. It is called that the total voltage drop around the loop must be always zero. Okay, that means what? Suppose you have connected one resistor here R1, one resistor here R2, okay, one voltage source you have connected here, that is V. Okay, so what is told according to the voltage law? According to the voltage law, when current flows, some voltage drop will appear across the resistor. Okay, and the total voltage in this loop must be always zero. Okay, when current flows through R1, suppose I current is flowing, so what if the current I is flowing through R1, what will be the voltage? V equals to IR, right? So here the voltage will be I into R1. I am writing this one as V1. Okay, and here due to the flow of I current, the voltage developed may be, suppose V2 equals to I into R2. Okay, when current flows through the resistor, it is called voltage drop. Remember, when current flows through any resistor or inductor or capacitor, that is called, that voltage is called the voltage drop across the resistor, or voltage drop across the inductor or capacitor, right? So why this voltage drop is called? Because this voltage is but nothing but the loss. Okay, this one is the source, this one is the loss. So we can write, according to the Kirchhoff's voltage law, V minus V1 minus V2 equals to zero. Okay, what we can say? V minus V1 minus V2 equals to zero. That means V equals to V1 plus V2. Also, you can say this, that the total amount of source voltage equals to the total amount of voltage drop that is happening in the circuit. Okay, now consider this circuit. Here the voltage drop, all the nodes are written here, check, A, B, C and D. Okay, so the voltage drop across AD or DA, okay, here the voltage drop is AB. Okay, we don't write here as AD, because our rotation must be same. So we will write here voltage DA, because we are moving from node D to node A, right? So here VAB, VBC, VCA, VCD, sorry, VCD and VDA. So when current flows through any resistor, that is nothing but a loss. So what is your source here? Source voltage is zero. Okay, now VAB plus VBC plus VCD plus VDA must be equal to zero. Okay, so this is the Kirchhoff's second law, or we can say it is the Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, this law is called the conservation of energy. Okay, but KCL law is called the conservation of charge. Do not get confused. Okay, now one example here in this circuit, you can see 10 volt source is here, 10 ohm resistor is connected, here 20 ohm resistor is connected, and in between at one point another resistor R3 is connected, right? And here another voltage source V2 of 20 volt is connected. Now check their polarity always. This is positive, this one is negative. this is positive, this one is negative. So what will happen here, according to the Kirchhoff circuit law, we will check the nodes first. Where are the nodes? Nodes are at A and B. Okay. Now, suppose the current I1 is flowing through this resistor R1, so 10 ohm. Okay. And we are considering that from this 20 volt source, I2 current is flowing through that 20 ohm resistor. Okay. So now we will form one loop here. That is the loop one, and this one is the loop two. Now, how these rotations are different? This rotation is here according to this current flow. Okay. When I1 current is flowing here, okay, at this node, I1 current is coming here. I2 current is flowing in from 20 volt to 20 ohm, right? So this I2 current is direction is like this. Okay. So at this node A, is there any path? Yes, there is an one path through which the all the incoming currents can flow. So that's why we wrote here I3 current is flowing through this branch. Okay. Now we will do what? We will do the Kirchhoff's voltage law. According to Kirchhoff's voltage law, what we remembered? We remembered the total voltage at the source. Total voltage at the source, that means 10 volt, must be equal to the voltage drop. So what is the value of the voltage drop? Here, I1 into R1. At this point, I3 into R3. Okay. So put the values, right? Just like that. If you consider the loop 2, the I2 value is, I2 current is flowing through R2 and I3 current is flowing through 40 ohm. And what is the source voltage? Source voltage is 20 volt. So 20 volt equals to I2 R2 plus I3 R3, right? So second equation you have derived. So two equations you have. Okay, but how many variables are here? There are three variables. First I1, then I2, and I3. So in our common thinking process, we can say that total three number of equations are required. Okay, so now what we will do? We will consider this total loop. Okay, where I1 and I2 is present only. Clear? Now, let me erase all the parts. Okay, now we consider only the outer loop. Now, what is happening in this outer loop? Watch very carefully. What is the potential here? This one is positive, this one is negative. So I am moving from 10 volt to 20 volt. Okay. So we are moving from minus to plus. That means we are gaining the potential. So we are writing as positive 10. Correct? Next. When current is flowing through the R1, what is this? That is voltage drop, right? So what is the sign of the voltage drop? The sign of the voltage drop must be negative, correct? So I am writing here minus 10 I1, Okay, I am going very slowly. So if you have any problem in understanding at any point, just let me know. Okay. Next, check. I1 is flowing in this direction. So our voltage drop is this one. And also, if you can remember, when current flows through the resistor, when current flows through one resistor, the polarity always like this, positive and negative. Okay, so I am writing here positive and negative. From here also you can say the significance of the negative sign. Why? Because you are moving from positive potential to negative potential. That means you are dropping your potential. That's why the negative sign is coming. Clear? Now, when I2 is flowing through 20, here what is happening? I2 is flowing in this direction. This is your resistance. Okay? So, where positive sign will be given? Here. And where negative sign will be given? Here. Okay? So, put this one. Now, minus. And this will be plus. So, what is happening when the whole loop is considered? Your potential is larger. Correct? That's why we are writing as plus 20. I2. Okay, next. When you are considering this voltage source, this one is positive, this one is negative pole, okay, negative polarity. So you are moving from positive to negative. That means you are dropping your potential. That means here it will be minus 20 sine. And according to Kirchhoff's voltage law, total voltage across any loop is zero. Okay. So from here we can write this equation 10 minus 20, this 10 minus 20, and I1, I2 are transferred into the right hand side. So here minus sign becomes the plus sign, and here plus sign becomes the minus sign. So three equations we are getting. Now you can solve it, I1, I2 and I3 value. Okay, till this numerical, is there any problem?
No, no, sir.
Very good. Okay, so now if three variables you are considering, that means what? Three equations are there and your total calculation becomes so hectic. Okay, it will take much more time. You have to solve I1, I2, I3, right? So we need to simplify these equations, okay, by some theorems. In the first class, I told you there are certain theorems that will be taught in the lectures. What are those theorems? Thevenin, Norton, and superposition. What are the advantages? Advantages are they reduce the number of variables. Okay, here what are the number of variables? Three. But in Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem, superposition theorem, they only consider two number of variables, or they reduce the total circuit in such a way that only one variable is present, right? Are you understanding what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is the main concept here. If you do like the raw way, like the loop, node, mesh analysis way, the total number of variables become larger. Okay, if you do by those theorems, they reduce this total circuit and converted the three number of variables, or maybe four number of variables, into two number of variables or one variable. Okay, so that is the advantage menu, nothing else. So if you solve these equations, you can calculate the I1, I2 and I3 value, and the respective voltages you can find out. Okay, so it is almost 152. So we are stopping here. Okay, everyone give your attendance in my chat box. Okay, so thank you everyone. I am concluding today's class with this numerical. Okay,
sir, you told that you will tell us, you tell us the book names or the PDF.
Yeah, I will upload that in Google Classroom. Okay, because it is almost 153. Okay, don't worry, sir. I will give that book name and the topics may be available or may not be. I don't have that idea. Okay, I will give you the book name. If you can find it, then it's okay. Okay, so give your attendance, and if you have given, then you may leave the meeting. Everyone give your attendance.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.